King, and I'm 16 years old, and I live in the West section of Philadelphia. I'm here today to talk about the issues that are important to me, and me being a youth in Philadelphia, me being 11th grade, colleges ahead, and just me being a 16-year-old female in Philadelphia. There are many different issues in Philadelphia, like violence, and then we have the political campaign that's coming up, and we have these issues that we as young people are impacted by, and basically the whole Pennsylvania and the whole United States and the whole world is eventually affected by. And this will maybe the system and everybody else, as young people, our views and our thoughts are always maybe disregarded and like looked down upon, like they don't count, but they actually do, because the voice of the young person or the voice or the idea or just the proposal of a young person can change everything. And basically the issues are, like I said before, violence, and how maybe as a young person that we can actually change, and as a citizen of Philadelphia that we can change, and do I feel, the question now is really, do I feel represented by the community, and do I feel represented by the political campaigns that's going on? And personally, I do, because maybe they're not saying personally, Efia, we represent you, but I believe that they actually do. Like one particular candidate, Barack Obama, he does represent like the middle class and how everything actually affects us, and actually affects from government to the adults to the children to the generations to come. And like I said before, views of young people do get looked down on or disregarded, or maybe our voice doesn't count, but they actually do. And personally, I do feel represented, but maybe sometimes I don't, like as a government or a mayor, or I know it's hard being in those high positions in government, but we actually have to regard and take into consideration what maybe an adult will say, or maybe a child might say, because they actually can change a whole section of Philadelphia, maybe change the whole Pennsylvania or United States, or even maybe evolve into the world. And what I can do to change is basically, you know, me being a citizen and me having those rights as a woman, or having the right as a female, a young female. I'm not old enough to vote yet, but when I do, I have to take into consideration, are they representing me? Are they regarding what I have to say? Are they actually looking to see what I have and what I can bring to the table, and what me as a young person, when I get older, as a lady, as the whole factors actually are a whole thing to make one package. And as a citizen of Philadelphia and Pennsylvania, it does get, especially as a young person, it does get hard to actually say what you feel and say what you think, because not everybody, but I mean, like I said, like it does get disregarded, or it does like, oh well, we'll get back to it, but I mean, not right now. And sometimes it does like get, oh well, I'm not gonna try, because maybe somebody will, oh, that's not good enough, or oh, you're not good enough, but it's just like, it's not competition, but you always have to work harder, you always have to be better, or you always have to say something, because it's like, you're always being compared, like, to somebody else, no matter how old you get, or how young you are, you're always being compared. And I think that is what I would look for, and like somebody representing me, is woman I admire, or is a man I admire, or is somebody high in stature in government, I would ask myself, well, does he share the same values as me? And I experienced the moment in the Atwater Kent Museum here in Philadelphia, where we actually went and we were representative of different sections of Philadelphia, like West Philadelphia, South Philadelphia, even Upper Darby and North Philadelphia, where we actually got a chance to experience what it feels like to be on a news crew or government, or actually a young child in a section of Philadelphia or an adult. And it actually gave me a chance to look at how much time and how much preparation and how much money and how much everything planning and it goes into actually changing something. But the thing about it was that the three main things, healthcare, education, and the economy, how they kept bringing us problems and problems and more problems, and problems were just piling on top of each other, and how we just kept having solving problems and problems and problems. And I know if the government, that's what they have. They have the three main things, and they keep their problems and problems. Even the president has problems and problems. But is the what you do with the problems, either you solve them or you just let them pile up. And then I was the section of West Philadelphia. We solved our problems, and even when we solved one, another one coming. And even like we couldn't have done it if everyone was sticking together, everyone wasn't making an effort, because you have to make an effort, and you have to, like, in order to your voice to be heard, you have to say something. Everyone is not a mind reader. You can't read minds. You have to say something. And even if you don't, you can write something. Like, it just won't be make an effort. And it brings me to my point about voting. You have to vote. I know it's a lot of commercials get out there and vote. Obama, McCain, Patrick Murphy, a lot of different people running. But you have to vote, or we don't have a right to complain. We have the right to vote. But if you don't vote, you don't have the right to complain. Oh, well, we're in a recession. Oh, we're going to Great Depression. Oh, Wall Street this, Wall Street that. If you do not vote, you don't have the right to complain. That's my standard. Like, even as a woman, not me personally, but I know I will get there. You know, you have a lot of things on your mind, like school, kids, job, what am I going to do next? But if you do not vote, you don't have, I'm not saying you don't have a right, because everybody as a human being has a right to do something, but you don't have the right to be, oh, well, I don't care, I can't change that. One voice can make a whole difference. I read an article, it was comparing how in 4 years that a percentage of people, of women didn't vote, and how that could have changed the outcome of election. It was comparing African Americans, Latinos, and Asian Americans, and how a wide percentage of them didn't vote, and it really could have changed the outcome of the election, and it may even change, like, if those percentages not vote, it may even change the person, like, the outcome of this election. So, wow.
And what are you doing?
And what am I doing? I am involved in now, and with me being in school, it does take up most of my time, but I am active in civic year. It's a community service project that we do. We go out, we talk about stereotypes, and we talk about the different schools and kids and service learning. And I'm actually active in the Obama campaign, and I go phone big call people, are you for Obama, are you not for Obama, will you volunteer? We have buttons, we have everything, signs and everything, like, just something, and it makes me feel good about myself, because I have that, like, oh, I went home, and I was like, wow, I actually am involved. Maybe it's not, maybe an hour, a half an hour, but I was actually involved in that. That's my answer to the question. Thank you.